okay, he's a new character and it's a part in a film. Like, when I'm finished, this is nothing I can show. I'm not glinking here. I only did this twice. You need to be there. One of the things I loved about working at Disney was that they used to assign you a part. They would give you a character. The excuse for having teams in 2D films was that we all had to learn to draw this character the same way. So it was easier to just specialize a group of people and they just all know how to draw it the same way. But to me, the consistency of the psychology of the character was always far more important than that. So to let that go and say, oh, we don't have to draw it anymore, so we're just not gonna have teams anymore. So if you're a Pixar, you're gonna get a shot from a different character every week, you know, and go, well, then you know, we don't really get to build up a character. We're kind of like, we have 70 people dabbing into that character and there's only so much you can do with that. The great thing about working on a single character is, okay, here's your character and it's a part in a film and you need to develop it. You need to also, you know, learn what kind of acting, what kind of nuances, how am I gonna build this up so it feels like a person as opposed to just a stereotype. Here's some of the things I would do. And I mean, being honest, I only supervised two characters. So it's not like I'm speaking from, I'm not Glenn Keane here. I only did this twice. I got Tantor on Tarzan and Doppler on Treasure Planet.
I've had it with you and your emotional constipation. Tarzan needs us.
You've tried everything. There are much worse remedies than a few character building months in space.
So different supervisors go different ways. Some people get really attached to the voice actor and try to learn and study the voice actor. I said that's always a bad thing. I prefer to forget that you're doing the voice. I don't want people to think about you when they see this character. I want them to think about a new character. So I would start collecting information. I would start thinking, well, I knew someone in high school who used to do this. It was kind of, so had the same personality. So what do you do? What did she do? And I was, oh, it is, okay, this, so they, and then I would remember an actor who did, an actress who did a part in a film, say, oh, you know, that was kind of the same character. So let me look at that and see what they did to solve the same problem. And see, I'm not gonna do the same thing, but I wanna see what they did, you know? And then you build it, and then you grab things and you create something new. Now, this looks like nothing. Like, when I'm finished, this is nothing I can show. Like, it will be a pile of papers. That makes no sense. It's really trying to get me to the point where I go, okay, if someone shows me a shot and this character is acting not the way he should, I'll know, and I'll know why. Does that make sense? So you just need to develop that sense of like, that's not her, or that is him, you know, and you wanna get there. So it's, I don't think there's a right or wrong way, but you need to be there, you need to get there. Because at some point, my job is gonna be to tell others why and how. And now that I'm directing, it's the same thing with a bigger scale. Like, that belongs to this film, that doesn't, that's her. And if you have written the story, it makes it easier because you know why you made those choices.